Hi, my name is Dave Logring, and I'm a member of the Microsoft Dynamics GP support team. With the upcoming changes to TLS and basic authentication on October 1st, 2022, and the implementation of MFA in Dynamics GP, troubleshooting for email issues will change. The purpose of this video blog is to introduce you to the Azure login log that is used when doing MFA troubleshooting in Dynamics GP. Until October 1st of 2022, if you have not enabled MFA for Dynamics GP, you can continue to use the email troubleshooting guide to solve most, if not all, email issues. On-premise Exchange does not use Dynamics GP MFA, and troubleshooting likewise can be done using the email troubleshooting guide. For my demonstration purposes, the steps to set up MFA for GP in Azure are already done. I'm using a developer domain for my testing. Before we look at some specific troubleshooting examples, let's review the sign-in log. First, you'll log into the Azure portal. Once you're in Azure, you're going to want to go into Azure Active Directory. On the left-hand side, you're going to want to scroll down to the monitoring section and select sign-in logs. This log records all logins for Office 365 and any Azure assets that are in the tenant. So we're going to want to filter this. The first thing that we will want to filter on is the application. The app that we registered in Azure when we were setting up our MFA, we're going to copy that name and we're going to go back and we're going to create a filter for application. Now, the second part of the filter that we're going to want to look at is the time. Now, my events all took place on the 24th of 2022. So we're going to filter out everything so it includes just that time period. If we're going to be doing user-specific filtering, we could add a further filter for the user. So these are all the user events that took place on the 24th into our application GP MFA app. And that's just a quick review of the sign-in log and how to filter. The Azure sign-in log can take 10 more minutes to update, so when doing troubleshooting, be patient. For my demonstration, I have taken a screenshot of an error received when registering the application ID in GP. The error received is an unknown error occurred. GP does not have a built-in log that records this error or provides any more details. We can, however, get these details from the Azure sign-in log. I generated this error at 4:10 p.m. on the 24th with my login, which is the Azure Global Admin. Let's review that error. The event here at 4:10, when we click on it, we can see the details. We can see several things. First, multi-factor authentication. We see that there was a failure. We see that there was an error code. We can look these error codes up, but most of the time we don't need to. There's a failure reason provided, and if we review that failure reason, we can generally figure out what the issue really is. We see here it says use a tenant-specific endpoint or configure the application to be multi-tenant. Taking a look at our GP MFA app, if we come down to authentication, review the supported account types, we can see that it is indeed set to single tenant. We'll change it to multi-tenant, save the application. After that change was made, I was able to register the app at 5:10 p.m. It was successful, but we'll review this just to get familiar with the log. Again, we see that multi-factor authentication was required. We see there was a success. There was no error code provided. The MFA completed in Azure AD. I created a few login failure situations so we can review the Azure sign-in log to see what details we can see there. The first failure was for GP user 1 at 9:36 a.m. We'll go back, we'll add in our filter for the user. And then we'll take a look at 9:36 a.m. for a login failure. Clicking on the details, there's several things that we can see. Multi-factor authentication was required. There was a failure. It gives us an error code that we, if needed, we could go look that up later. The reason it tells us is it failed during the strong authentication request. It tells us the user didn't complete the MFA prompt. Well, that's still not a lot of details, but the other thing we can do, we can launch the sign-in diagnostics. The first thing it does, it'll start filtering based on the event that we clicked on. We can see it's still querying for the sign-in event. Once it does update, we'll see that it is running diagnostics right here. Once that fully loads, we can scroll down and review some of the authentication details. The first thing we notice is that the password in the cloud results other. What I had done, I had logged into Edge with this user into the Office 365 portal. I saved the password in Edge. So the password actually fed over from Edge, and that's how it came up with the result of other. When the application on my phone popped up, I actually clicked deny, and that is ultimately the reason why the authentication failed. Let's review another event. On the 24th at 9:54 a.m., we see an event status of interrupted. I manufactured a network slowdown by restricting network traffic to 1 megabyte to the virtual machine during the login process to demonstrate the effects. In GP, the approved sign-in request faded out for several minutes until it eventually left the screen and email login failed. Let's review that event. We can see that we got multi-factor authentication is required. The status was interrupted. So let's take a look at some of the details. Now again, it's searching for the specific event that we logged onto or clicked onto. Once it finds the event, it'll run its analysis. And as we come down, we can see some of the details here. And we see correct password. We see MFA successfully completed, but we end up with the status of interrupted. From the review of the Azure log, all should have worked, but it gives us the status of interrupted. The request came into Azure. The MFA request went to the phone and was approved, but the final results could not be sent to the requesting application. The only clue that a network issue occurred is the interrupt status in the Azure login log. This would be indicative of an intermittent network issue between the GP server and Azure AD. For the next event, I disabled MFA for our GP user 1 and used an incorrect password. Clicking on that event, we see single factor authentication, meaning there was just a password that was required. We see failure. The error, validating credentials due to invalid username or password. If we were to go in to launch the sign-in diagnostics, it'll take a moment to load. After about 40 seconds or so, it is loaded. If we take a look, we see that the sign-in failed. The password or other credential was incorrect. That's exactly what we expected to see. Let's take the time to review a successful login with MFA enabled. Here, we see that multi-factor authentication was required. It was successful. Let's look at the diagnostics for a moment. Once the diagnostics is fully loaded, we can see here, obviously the status was a success. But if we come down here, we see that it references conditional access policies. Demonstrating the effects of conditional access policies is outside the scope of my demonstration today. But if one were in place that did interrupt or block the login, it would be listed here. We will look at one more scenario, but it's more to demonstrate the filter use in the Azure sign-in log. We have another user, GP user 2, that we will review the user's sign-on activity. We'll reset our filter to GP user 2. As you can see, they only have one event. It was a single factor, meaning they only required a password and they were successful. I want to thank you for watching this video. Email troubleshooting will change once you enable MFA for Dynamics GP. The first place to look will be the Azure AD sign-in log to determine if the issue is with the registered Azure app, the user's permissions in Azure, or if it is an authentication issue. If everything checks out in the Azure AD sign-in log, we can then focus on module-specific email issues and/or use the Dynamics GP email troubleshooting guide. The goals of this presentation were to give you an introduction to Azure AD sign-in logs and how they can be used to troubleshoot MFA email login issues. We also looked at a specific application ID registration error and the corrective action for that. We then went through several different login scenarios and reviewed those. Hopefully, this information will assist you in the future when performing general email troubleshooting when MFA is enabled in Dynamics GP.